Hello everyone. So I am Professor Dattatray Gandhmal from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see hash table in collections. So till now in collections, we have seen a lot of varieties, like we have seen array list, stack, queue, etc. Right? So now moving on to next important collection type is hash table. So what exactly we are going to learn? The learning outcome of this video will be a student will be able to describe hash table along with various methods. So we have lot of methods in every collection, so we are going to explore them. Second, each student will be able to write a program using hash table in collection. So we will have a short demonstration on how to write a hash table program, and we'll try to learn out of it. Okay. Now, coming to hash table, what is hash table and why it is required? Hash table stores items as key value pairs. Okay. So till now we have seen that array list stores only one entry we have in array list, or we can say stack or queue. But when we come to hash table, we need to enter key and value pairs. Okay. So it will take two parameters as an input, key and value. I'll come back to it later. Each item in the hash table is uniquely identified by its key. So key is unique. Value can change, and key will also change, but key should be unique. You cannot have a repeated key element. Okay, therefore we name it as key in an object. So they are stored as an object type. So everything you put it in as a key value pair, that will be stored as an object. Okay, so mostly string class is popular, but it is not restricted. Okay, you can use any data type for storing hash table, or any object type to store into the hash table, but mostly strings are used. Okay. Now, what are the steps to create hash table? An hash table can be constructed in this manner. Hash table ht equal to new hash table. This is blank entry of hash table. Okay. This only object is created ht without passing any parameter over here. This is simplest way to create object of hash table. Ht can be anything. Another way to specify is giving some capacity, rough capacity here. I am giving the capacity as 12. It can be anything. But remember that whatever value we are going to give it here, it is not going to restrict in any manner. That means even if I am specifying it as 12, I can enter more than 12 elements. I can enter less than 12 elements. I can enter 12 elements irrespective of what value I am specifying. This is only for users. Perseverance, like, okay, hash table is not going to be more than 12. It's just for perseverance. Later, it may increase to any stage. So with that flexibility, we have with collections. Now coming to program, shall we do a simple program on hash table? Okay. Now for doing this, we will come to Sharp Develop. Okay. So the procedure to start with is, I'll tell you from the beginning, file, new, solution. Okay, Sharp Dev Windows application, console application, give the name as demo hash. I'll give it as demo hash. It can be anything. Now this program is created. I'll delete this comment part for ease of understanding. Okay. Now, as we have seen earlier, that one namespace which is required for collections is system using system dot collections. This is very important. Okay, then only we will be able to create its object and use its method. So here I'll be using hash table. Hash table ht equal to new hash table. So first procedure we have seen is that empty. Let us try with empty one. Okay. Now, if I want to add an element to hash table, it will be ht dot add. Here, I'll be adding two parameters. One is the key and another is its value. At 10, let us assume that we have Sachin. Ht dot add. I'll enter one more key. Let us give the key as 7. And I'll write it as Dhoni. Okay, likewise I can put ht dot add, we'll have 18, and I guess it is right, numbers are right, Kohli, irrespective of that, but still I'm following. Okay, so Sachin 10, 7 and 18. Okay, this is how I'm inserting three elements. Here 10 is the key and Sachin is the value. Okay, so key should be unique as per the definition of hash table. Value can be repeated. Okay, for example, I can write ht.add 18 with another Zahir. I can write it like this. But here there will be an error saying that repeated key. 18 is getting repeated here. So key can change. So if I make it 27 and I write here instead of Zahir Kohli, this is fine. Value can be repeated, but key should not be repeated. Okay, this is acceptable. This is how hash table stores the values. Okay, now if I want to print it, I'll be using a for each loop. For each int I in what? HT dot. I need to specify where. Whether you want to print the key or whether you want to print the values. So it depends. I'll be printing keys. Okay. So here I'll be printing I. This is how I'll be inserting elements into hash table. Okay. I hope it is pretty clear from it. Let us check whether we are doing it right or wrong. Yes, exactly right. 18, 10 and 7 is getting printed. So the way I have added it and we have printed it, that's it. If I want to print values, I'll be using one more for each loop. For each int j in ht dot values. Okay, so I can have this once again. Instead of I, here it will be j. Now the values will be printed instead of keys here in the second for loop. So in my console screen, just a minute, ht.keys here. Okay, the type is string here. I am taking it as integer. It should be of type string. Okay, string j in this part. Try to execute. Okay, 18, 10, 7, Kohli, Sachin and Dhoni. Okay, this is how it is getting printed. Fine. Now what else methods we have here? Let us see. HT dot. There is a clear, there is a clone, contains key. So I can check whether if a particular element is contains or not. HT dot contains. I can check whether Sachin is present in it or not. So it will be, obviously it will return a Boolean value, that is true or false. Okay, likewise I can play with all these ready-made methods which are there in collection. That is the biggest advantage of using collections. You have all these methods readily available. You can remove a particular element. You can convert it to two string, particular string. You can check its equal or not. So you can clone it. You can clear the every collection which you have created. So all these methods are present inside it. Okay, let us come to our presentation. There is a small question for you people. How items are identified in hash table? Okay, you can take a pause and answer it. The answer for this is using key. As I said, key is unique in collections. Every collection item is identified by its key. So keys are very, very important. I hope you have answered it rightly. Now, methods in hash table. These are some popular methods, not limited to, most frequently used methods for hash table. Add. This is, we have just now seen it, that how to add an element into hash table. Remove. You can name a specific element with its key and you can remove it. So removing will be on key basis. Why? Because keys are unique. That's what is making it different. Second is clear. Next is clear. Clear means everything will be removed. All elements from a hash table will be removed. Contains is to check, as I said, a specific element is present or not. That again, we do it with a specific key. So keys are very, very important. Values are just data which is stored at that particular location. You can take it in that way. Okay, get hash returns the hash code of a specific key. So every object in C hash is having a hash code, and that hash code can be obtained by using a method called as get hash. Okay. These are some of the references which I have used. And one more thing I forgot here is we can also ht dot contains key. There are two methods, contains and contains key. What is the difference between contains and contains key? We can explore them also. Contains key, whether it contains a particular key. So I can say here contains key 10. I can make it into an if ht dot contains key 10, it is going to return a true or false. If it is containing, I will do some activity, otherwise not. This we can do with this method. Also ht dot, you can also remove a particular element. Here you can see that it is saying that object key, we need to specify a key. So let's say I will remove 7. ht dot remove 7 should remove Dhoni from the list. Okay, now if I print this for each loop once again after removing, it should not have Dhoni in the list. Okay, so first time this 18, 10, 7, Kohli, Sachin, Dhoni is getting printed, and after removing I am printing 18, 10, 7 is not there and Dhoni is not there. So this is how we can remove an element from hash table. Okay, so that's it from this video. I hope you have understood it. Okay, thank you.